In this video, I'm gonna be redesigning this orange juice carton packaging, which is sourced locally from my fridge. This is an Asda's own orange juice carton, and it is in need of some serious design help to try and help market it better when sat on the shelves next to big brands like Tropicana and Innocent. That is where I come in, the Magic Design Fairy, where I'm gonna be redesigning the packaging. So let's look at the original design so we know what to tweak and what to keep. Things I quite like are the boldness of the orange and the capital letters of orange juice. Things that need to change are the blue box and the images of fruits. With that in mind, let's start pouring into the process of the redesign. The first stage is taking a look at other packaging and seeing exactly where we want to market this brand. We will also be having a look at what other competitors are doing. So here are six different carton packaging that are out in the supermarkets and sat on the shelf. If I'm honest, I would probably only pick up one of these, which is the Innocent Smoothie Bottle, because the logo is quite fun and it suits the shape of the bottle. But with all of the others, I probably would not even look twice at these, just from the design aspect alone. But we are gonna try and change that. So there's actually some quite common patterns that I'm noticing across all of the packaging. One, using real life photography to showcase the orange juice instead of design elements or drawings. Two, using either a milk-like carton shape or a plastic curved bottle. Three, using white, orange, and blue colors throughout. With all that being said, we are gonna keep with the milk carton packaging and go for an organic look. I don't think the plastic bottle shape will work well with this organic feel. So I've drawn out a simple template so I have something to go from when designing the carton. Let's top the drink up and go on to the next stage, which is designing the carton box. Let's start with picking the background color. With all the competitors, the common themes are bright orange or a lot of white space. So to stand out, we can mix this up and go for something a little darker, like a dark green, to keep it organic and symbolize the leaves on an orange tree. Next is adding in the fruit. We're gonna stay away from the common theme of using real photography, as I feel like this makes it slightly outdated and not so modern. Instead, we're gonna add in some hand-drawn elements and shapes to really add to that organic and homegrown feel of the oranges. We're not gonna make it too cartoon-like, as this will take away from that organic and mature feel of the brand. So we've now got some beautiful hand-drawn oranges and leaves to showcase this in the best way. I don't know about you, but at the moment, the design feels a little flat. So I'm gonna tweak some of the green colors and adjust them with different shades of green to add in that aspect of light. Then we're gonna add in a gradient to the oranges to make them look more 3D, which should make them appear bigger and stand out to the eye. Now it's time to add in those little design elements that are gonna lift the brand. We're gonna add lines to the leaves and add some little dots to the oranges to add to that organic and homegrown feel. Perfect. Adding in those little design elements has really lifted this design and also made it feel less flat. Next, what I feel like is missing on a lot of the competitors' packaging is everything feels displaced and the design feels like it's working against the shape of the box. For example, with this packaging design, there is a lot of orange space above and below the design, which could be utilized in a much better way. Therefore, we're gonna add in a box to the middle of our design and shape the oranges and leaves around this box, making the positioning feel really comfortable to the eye. Using overlapping elements is a great way to do this, as the box will feel like it's happily placed there and not just sat on top. The box color is going to be an off-white cream to match the warm tones of the oranges, and the lid can also match this color, which will add in a perfect contrast with the dark green. Let's pour in some more drink and go on to the typography. So I actually don't mind the original typography on this packaging. The only thing that is really bugging me is the different font sizes. So we're gonna make sure that we keep ours consistent and use a bold typeface. So I've got three options that I quite like. Number one is a bold condensed font, two, a sans serif font, three, a bold display font. So I really like the look of the bold condensed font. It works really nicely, it's clean, and the condensed part makes it feel like it's been squeezed a little tighter than a wider font, fitting in perfectly with the squeezing element of making the orange juice. Now I've chosen a complimentary sans serif font for the extra words of smooth and from concentrate. I've sat these above and below orange juice to balance the design out and make the main focus around the orange juice. So your eyes will read orange juice, smooth, and then from concentrate. We can now arrange where the Asda logo can go, as this is used on the original packaging. I quite like the positioning of the original design, which works nicely with our design. The only thing that I'm changing is the color of the logo to white to fit in better with our overall design. Let's fill the cup up more and go on to adding in the correct labels on the packaging. We need to add in exactly what was on the original packaging, so things like the calories, sugars, saturates, etc. So next, I'm going to redesign the side of the packaging and use all of the elements that we've used on the front of the package. This is the original design, and I'm not going to lie, that is a lot going on and it's making me feel kind of uneasy. So to simplify it, we are going to align the text, put the text in an order of what we want people to read first, and now add in our design elements. I've tweaked some of the words just to make it more mature and fit in with the organic and homegrown feel. I honestly feel so more at ease just looking at this with those small tweaks that we have added. Let's fill the glass up fully and go on to the last stage, which is presenting our work in the best possible way. So to do this, I'm gonna use mockups, and my go-to place is Envato Elements that I always use for client work and showcasing my work on Instagram. So they are the sponsor of this video, and if you wanna check them out, make sure you click the link in my description so you can use them too. They actually have some awesome orange juice cartons that I'll be using to showcase this design. The design has now been placed in the mock-up, and as you can see, it is such a good way of showcasing your designs in a real life situation. So we have completely redesigned the packaging of the orange juice carton into something completely different to what the competitors are doing. And I'm not gonna lie, I would pick this up off of the design aspect alone. So, without further ado, let me introduce you to the new and improved Asda's own orange juice carton packaging. Asda, eat your heart out. Let me know your thoughts on the design process and if my design beats the original carton design. If you have enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and I will see you at the next video.